Welcome to my talk. I'm talking about iSinger 2 and the brand new API of iSinger 2. My name is Achim. I am a systems engineer at NetWays, and I mainly do DC automation for the managed service part within NetWays, and I work for NetWays since 2012. So in our hosting company, we do our virtual machines with OpenNebula, and of course for monitoring we use iSinger. So as NetWays, we do the main development part for iSinger. So I want to know from you, who knows iSinger? Who knows what iSinger is? Okay, great. Who uses iSinger in production? Some of you. Okay, thank you. For the rest, I just give a really short introduction. What is iSinger? iSinger is just a monitoring system. It's basically scalable and extensible, and it does what every monitoring system does. It notifies you if your resources are not available. That's all. And just to mention some of the best features of iSinger 2, I will do this just in one slide. What is the best thing? I think what's the best on iSinger 2? The best thing is it's distributed and it's high available. So I'm not having one instance of iSinger usually. I have more instances of iSinger who can distribute the load of the service checks, who are always high available. That means if one instance failed, the server failed, just a second instance take over the work and doing the checks. And I can group these instances of iSinger into different zones. So maybe I have two instances for monitoring Europe. I have two instances for monitoring the zone in the Asian market. And I have still one interface or a third zone where I can put all the data together and have a central view of all my different zones, data centers, whatever. So the zoning support or the distributed and high availability feature is one of the best things I think iSinger provides. And for me as a system engineer, the new configuration format is really, really, really good. And it's user-friendly, it's rule-based, so I can just create a service checks, check who monitors all my Linux machines or all my machines with APT installed. With one single service check. So these are the key features from my point of view. And I said I want to talk about the API. And so the API is the next big thing, which is really great in iSinger. With the API, I can modify and I can create the configuration of iSinger. And this is the key part to integrate the monitoring configuration with other tools. So in, later we'll see an example how to integrate it with OpenNebula. So how do I install the API or how do I enable the API in iSinger 2? I just create an IPA user config object. The API itself, it's an HTTP API with a RESTful URL schema, and the authentication is through basic authentication or through X509. So what can I do with the API? I just can create, modify, and delete configuration objects. I can create or modify all objects, expect constants because they are constants, and the next thing I can do is I can retrieve information and run actions from my monitoring system, and I can subscribe to events. So I can get all actions, all or whatever is going on in my monitoring system. I can get on an event subscriber and can do whatever I used to do. I can use it for notifications. I can use it for logging. I can use it for whatever I want. So what can I do in consonance OpenWR with the API? The easiest example I can think about is to use the hooks to create a monitor a host, a virtual machine, when I create it. So on the left side, you see an OpenNebular hook, or you see two hooks. It's one VM hook for creating virtual machines. And below, you see a VM hook when deleting virtual machines. It's just a few lines of code in the 1D conf. And whenever a machine is created, I call a script. It's called, in this basic example, create host. And whenever a machine is created, a virtual machine, the create host script on the right side is executed. And in this case, it's just a short curl. It's running against the Isinger 2 API. And I send some JSON, the minus D flag, to the API. I just give the host an address. I give some variables like Linux or host groups or whatever I want. And that's all I need to create, to monitor a host within creating a new VM. I showed this in a short example. This is the Isinger web interface. I have here some basic hosts. This is just a demo case. This is just a Vagrant box, just to have something to play around to see what Isinger 2 can do for you. And here I have my hosts. I can just click on it and have some more details. I have tabs with the services. Example, just I choose a HTTP host. I have a service. I have all the details of the service. Is it okay? Is it responding? And if I like, I have some graphs here too. So, and on the next tab, I have my OpenNebular sandbox. It's an old version, it's 5.0. And I installed the hooks within the sandbox. And when I now create a new virtual machine, I choose the TTY Linux template and just create it. And with creating with creating the VM, it should be here in the, it should now be here in the host list. What's going on? You can see now here is a host. It's called 24. It's because I just used the ID as name. It's easier to map in the moment. This is the host we created, the TTY Linux VM we created just in OpenNebular. I can do some check on it. As you have seen, there's just the IP 8888. It's the DNS server from Google. And now the VM can be monitored. And when I delete the VM, it should go away. I have to wait. It's done in OpenNebular, and now it should disappear from our host list. Okay, it's already gone. You see host not found error. Okay, the error message is not nice, but the host is deleted. This is a really basic way how you can monitor your virtual machines with Isinger 2 in cooperation with OpenNebular. You can do a lot of more things. If you provide your OpenNebular template with more basic information, you can use this information just to feed the monitoring system through the hook. And so it's really easy to do. That was my demo. What have you learned? It's really nice if you build software to provide an API or to provide, in the OpenNebular case, the hooks, because it's easy to integrate them with all your stack, with the other components of your stack. If you want to try it by yourself, just get the Isinger 2 Vagrant boxes. You do a Vagrant app and have a fully featured demo of Isinger 2 with graphing and everything around. And the same is for the OpenNebular sandbox. Just fire it up and you can play around with the hooks and with the API to integrate your features, your stack. Thank you very much. Any questions?
Hi, I just wanted to ask if you can put a link to the JSON query you did on in the forum or somewhere so we can look at it.
There are examples for the Isinger 2 API. Just Google Isinger 2 API examples. There's a GitHub repo where you find the basic examples.
Okay.
How scalable is it? You said it was scalable, but how much can you actually make it monitor?
It is very performant. You can do mainly, I think, about 50,000 hosts with one server, but you can just add more servers. The check contribution will be done automatically if they are in the same zone, and you can just add more hosts if you need it. But really big instances or big customers of ours don't need very much servers for monitoring. It's just monitoring. It's not a database, or you just need basically some CPU, and that's all. So you will be happy with some hosts.
Any more questions? Okay, thank you very much.